Welcome to your guide to breast lift surgery. Take a few minutes to familiarize yourself with the procedure and what you can do to help improve your results. Remember, this presentation does not take the place of your consultation, and you should make sure to jot down any questions you may want to ask us later. Breast lift surgery, or mastopexy, is a common plastic surgery procedure that can return your breasts to a more youthful shape and position. Improving the contour of your breast may help you gain self-confidence, enhance your self-esteem, and expand your clothing choices. Physically healthy women with realistic goals are good candidates for this surgery. In some cases, breast implants are used in conjunction with a breast lift to improve shape and restore volume. How will your breast lift be performed? There are different techniques that can be used, depending on the amount of correction desired. If your breasts require minimal correction, the concentric or periareolar technique may be an option for you. With this technique, donut-shaped incisions are made around the areola border. The vertical incision technique is generally performed when a more moderate lift is necessary. It begins similarly to the concentric technique, except that additional incisions are made that come down from both sides of the incision around the areola border and end at the breast crease. In some cases where a larger degree of correction is necessary, the anchor or keyhole incision may be used. In this technique, the incisions roughly resemble an old-fashioned keyhole, circling around the areola, down the breast, and across the breast crease. With each of these techniques, once the incisions have been made, excess breast tissue, skin, and fat are removed. The nipples are moved to their new higher locations, and the skin is tightened to give a new shape to your breast. The incisions are closed using very fine stitches and then taped to help reduce scarring. You will also be fitted with a support bra to help you heal and make you feel more comfortable. Together, we will select the technique that will provide the best result for you. When you meet with our patient coordinator, we will discuss fees and costs. Preparation. Every woman has a unique perspective on what may be the best shape for her breasts, and your goals will affect the way your breast lift is performed. It is important to discuss your desires and listen closely during the consultation so that you can set realistic expectations. A great result can only be achieved when there is good communication between us. You will also need to understand that the shape you have before surgery will partially determine the shape you have after surgery. Some suggestions to help you prepare for surgery. Your safety matters to us. You should be very open. Provide your medical history, drug allergies, list any previous surgeries or biopsies, medications, diet pills, vitamins, and herbs you are taking, even if you don't think they're important. Also, don't be afraid to be frank with us about your lifestyle, smoking, the strenuousness of the work you perform, your exercise habits, and the importance of getting back to work. Here are some tips that may help you reduce scarring, shorten your recovery time, and decrease your chances of complications. Discontinue using aspirin, ibuprofen, naproxen, St. John's wort, and vitamin E for 1 week before and a few days after your procedure. These act as blood thinners and could cause problems with blood clotting. Stop smoking and drinking alcohol in excess, well in advance of your breast lift, and for 1 week after surgery. Drink lots of water in the days leading up to your breast lift. Hydration will help you recover more quickly. To make your recovery easier and more comfortable, be sure to arrange for someone to take you home and take care of you for at least the first 24 hours. Fill your prescriptions prior to surgery and place them within easy reach of where you will be resting. Place plenty of pillows or a bed wedge nearby so that you can keep your back elevated. Have several loose-fitting button-down blouses ready to wear in your new breast size. Recovery. You should expect some bruising, swelling, and pain for the first week or two. Stitches will come out or be absorbed on their own between a week and 10 days. Swelling may linger for as long as 1 to 2 months. Pain medications will be prescribed to control the discomfort. However, if you begin to have severe pain, contact us immediately. You will also want to avoid raising your arms above shoulder level during the first few days after surgery. The recovery process is different for everyone, but within a day of your breast lift, you should be up and walking around. If your job is not overly strenuous, you should plan on being out of work and away from your usual activities for the first week. Over the next 2 or 3 weeks, your breast may be very sensitive, and strenuous physical activities should be limited. You will need to wear a support bra for about 1 month. Following this period, you may gradually return to activities such as lifting, exercise, and sex. While there will be permanent scars, they will be well hidden when you're wearing clothing, even when you're wearing a swimsuit in most cases. The scars are usually small and become difficult to see as they heal over time. The appearance of your breast should improve over a period of several months. Final results vary woman to woman and can be long-lasting. What are the risks of breast lift surgery? This information is not intended to frighten you, but to help you make an informed decision. No question or concern is silly or insignificant. We will be happy to discuss the full range of potential complications and answer any questions you might have regarding this procedure. Though the breast lift procedure is a well-established surgical procedure, there are risks of complications. Just as in any operation, bleeding, infection, and scar formation can occur. Asymmetry in size, skin loss, and decreased or loss of nipple sensation. In a small percentage of patients, additional surgery may be necessary. Breast lift surgery does not normally interfere with pregnancy, but if you are planning to have a baby, your breast skin may stretch and offset the results of your breast lift, and you may have more difficulty breastfeeding after this operation. All women should start routine mammogram screening by the age of 40 or earlier if there is a family history of cancer. Be sure to let your technician know if you have had a breast lift. You should also continue monthly breast self-examinations and annual physical examinations. As with all medical procedures, be sure to choose your surgeon wisely. It is important to choose an experienced surgeon you can trust and develop a good rapport with, so you can openly discuss your concerns and particular needs throughout the process of consultation, surgery, and aftercare. Should you decide to move forward with your breast lift, a surgery date will be scheduled. Prior to surgery, you will be given complete preparation and recovery instructions. Remember to keep your follow-up visits, as we are here to help make this a wonderful experience for you. Feel free to review any part of this presentation you like, and be sure to take a look at our before and after gallery to get a better idea of the results you may achieve.